Do you still see him having a really good career going forward?
Me and Josh, I mean, our relationship has grown over the year to be like something like real special. I mean, he's a young player willing to learn. I mean, his career gonna go over wherever he wants his career to go. I mean, he's puts in the work and does everything that I'll try to compete anybody. So, I mean, he's a hard worker. So, I mean, he motivates me and we compete every day at practice or whatever. Like, so, you know what I mean? So.
Okay, thank you.
No problem.
All right, we'll go to Demetrius.
Hey, Malcom. Obviously, this year hasn't gone the way that you guys have wanted it to. Heading into next year with a new head coach, you've been around very successful head coach and a person to lead them moving forward.
You kind of breaking out. I can't really.
Could you hear me?
Yeah, you're breaking out towards the end, though.
Just what do you think this team needs as far as a coach moving forward?
I mean, somebody who come in, you know, I mean, I guess get the organization going in the winning direction. I mean, I know that kind of sounds cliche or whatever, but I mean, we just need somebody to come in with a system or something, just get everything going right. I don't know what's right or wrong. I mean, I'm just a player. I mean, I just come in here and play ball, whatever they coach me up to do and want me to do on the field. I try to go out there and do my best at doing that. I mean, as far as like the coaching, you know what I mean? I don't know. Our question.
Understandable. Appreciate it.
No problem.
I don't see any hand raised. Anybody have any questions for Malcom? Oh, D-Rock.
Hey, Malcom, how tough has this season been for you? You know, it obviously didn't turn out the way everybody expected, but I mean, you, like Demetri said, you've been in some other places too. You've kind of been, you know, around a little bit. How tough has this season been for you?
I mean, it's been another season. I mean, I'm just a player who takes it week by week. I know everything else is going on, but I'm still in like football mode. So I'm still focused on the Colts and I'm still trying to win a game this week. So I ain't really had time to just sit back and think about the whole season in general. But I mean, as far as, you know, losing so many games in the season, this and that, I mean, I don't really want to speak to the past. Like I said, I'm still in game mode and still on to the Colts. But I mean, it's a hard feeling. But I mean, that's for any team that comes in at the beginning of the year. You want to win as many games. You want to set yourself up for success at the end of the year. So to be where we're at now, I mean, I know all of us are feeling it. So, that's it. But we're still focused. We're still trying to get this win, and we're still trying to go out with the right way.
Thank you.
No problem.
All right, we'll go to John Reed, and then we'll finish up with Demetrius.
Hey, what would be the satisfaction to try to get a win and end this eight-game win losing streak? If you can, you know, is there motivation to knock the Colts from making the playoffs, or just what's the motivation for Sunday's game?
I mean, to go out and play ball. I mean, go out and try to win the game. That's the motivation for real. I mean, we're just trying to, like I said, go out and execute mind right now. I mean, there ain't no special goals or anything. We just want to go out, you know what I mean, play a complete game like we've been trying to do all year and end the season off right.
All right, Demetrius, finish up with you.
Hey, yeah, sorry. I just want to follow up on what John said, actually. The Colts are in a position where they need to win this game in order to reach the playoffs, or I think they need help if they lose. Is that sort of another motivating factor for you guys to go out there and perform well?
I mean, I don't know no motivating factors. I just know we're trying to go out and get a win, and that's the goal every Sunday that we touch the field, you know what I mean? So the goal is still ain't changed no matter the circumstances of the year, you know what I mean? The goal is still to go out and get a dub. So that's all our focus right now is, you know, on the game plan and trying to get do that.
Appreciate it.
All right, thanks, Malcolm. You're all set. Appreciate it.
No problem.
All right, we're going to jump right into questions, all right?
All right.
All right, we're going to start with Gary Smits.
Hey, Walker, how you doing?
Doing well. How are you?
Not bad. A couple things. First of all, you may have to go back to training camp for this memory, but what's the tough thing about blocking Josh Allen?
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of things. He's big, he's strong, he's athletic, he's quick. I'd say that one of his best attributes, though, is just his tenacity. He never stops. You can block him, you know, his first move, and he's got another move coming. And so he's a hard worker and a great leader for this team. And he's made me a lot better.
Okay. And then speaking of a lot better, where do you think you've made the most strides from day one of training camp to right now?
I think biggest thing for me was just getting used to playing NFL talent, getting used to, you know, being better with my hands, being better with their feet, kind of the whole deal. I mean, the next level, if you have any kind of mishap, any little mistake, it'll be shown at a big scale. And so, you know, there's no opportunity to mess up. You got to be really precise each and every day. And I think just going through practices and going against guys like Josh, it really forced me to get better and forced me to be really precise with everything. And so I've been working on it all year. I think it's been helping me out a lot.
Okay, thank you.
All right, we'll go to John Reed.
How you doing? Could you share just what was your high points and low points of this season from an individual standpoint?
Yeah, I mean, obviously the low points is just we haven't been able to win as many games as we wanted to. We came into this year with a lot of high hopes and weren't able to really achieve quite everything we wanted to this season. But the high points, I think, is just, getting back to football. Obviously, the end of my college career was difficult. I wasn't able to play a whole lot. So getting back in the locker room, getting back into this locker room, specifically this O-line room, getting coached at a really great level with Coach Warhop. I just felt like I've been able to get a lot better. I'm being surrounded with great talent behind guys like Juwan and Cam. And so I'd say those are the high points.
What do you take away that you feel from, you know, the snaps you received this season? But what do you feel you have to work on to improve in certain areas of your performance?
Yeah, I mean, I think the biggest thing is just being consistent with my footwork and consistent with my hands. Those are just the things I try to work on. I feel like I have an image where I can block anyone in this league, but you got to be able to consistently do it each snap, having, you know, good sets, good angles. And so that's the thing I try to work on in practice. It's just, you know, not letting up at all and being precise with everything I'm doing.
And just one more thing. What worked for you so well last week against the Patriots? I mean, we got numbers like you had a perfect rating and things. What did you feel from your viewpoint that you did well to have a game like that?
I feel like one of the biggest things was just I had a lot more confidence going out there, having played in some games before, and just, you know, coming kind of to the end of the season, I feel like I've gotten a lot of reps against some of our great pass rushers. I've gotten a few reps in games and stuff. And so really being able to go out there confident and just calm and play my game, I feel like that was the biggest thing.
Thank you, man.
Demetrius?
Hey, Walker. I'm not sure if we were able to talk to you after the Bills game, but you were sort of thrown into the fire there. How did that go for you? And then sort of contrast that with having the week of preparation for this game against the Patriots and then obviously this week against the Colts.
Yeah, obviously the Bills game was a great opportunity. But yeah, I mean, it was right in pregame warmups. I found out that I was going to be starting that one. So it definitely was a little bit of shock to it. But it was a great opportunity and kind of my first chance to kind of be thrown on the fire. I wouldn't say, you know, it was a perfect performance, but I thought I did a lot of good things and it gave me a lot of things to build on, you know, versus this time around, kind of knowing and being on the prep, getting reps with the first team. And that kind of just helped with the confidence going into it and being able to be a little bit more calm, knowing just having taken reps all week. I think that helps with anyone. And so, yeah, I think those were the biggest things.
And have you been working at right tackle and left tackle in practice this season?
Yes, I have.
How much more comfortable have you gotten on that right side? I know in the beginning it might have been a little bit of a shock.
Yeah, I definitely said in the beginning it was definitely different for me. It took a little bit, but now I feel very comfortable. I feel just comfortable on the left and the right side. I've been doing it all season now, and so yeah.
Appreciate it.
All right, I don't see any more hands raised. Does anybody have anything else for Walker? All right, appreciate it, Walker. You're all set.
Yep. Thank you.